welcome to Adept English, and this is day 5 of our free 7-day course. We're getting through it now. So the usual deal, you've received an email with a video link and an MP3 file and a PDF file. Just to do a little recap, rule 1 on this course is to understanding first. Understanding is the most important thing. And you do this by lots of listening. Rule 2 says practice. Repeat your listening to the same thing a number of times. And number 3 says use your schedule. Find time when your brain's not fully occupied to do your English practice and stick at it. Rule 4 says little by little is normal in your learning, but make sure that your inner critic doesn't get hold of it and doesn't discourage you. So be nice to yourself. Rule 5 today says nothing but English. On my courses you won't hear me speak any other language than English. This is purposeful. This gets around one of the worst things about traditional language learning. Traditional language learning often gives you vocab lists, so it gives you a list of the words you're trying to learn and the translation into your own language. That's okay if you're just beginning. You need to have some basis to start with. But once you're aiming at fluency, it's much better to immerse yourself in the language you're trying to learn. So to get away from the idea of translation. Now, Adept English gives you two different ways here. We use a lot of context, so I'll introduce new words to you in context and I'll give you the explanation of the words in simple English so that there's no looking up, you just need to listen. So for example, a little story in context. Every Easter, we celebrate Easter in the UK and we have a little holiday, and every Easter my children say, "Oh, please can we make an Easter cake?" Now this involves baking a chocolate cake, and then we get a knife and we cut a section, we hollow out the top and we make it into a nest. And we cover it with chocolate and we rough it up with a fork so it looks a bit like a bird's nest. And then we get some mini eggs and we put lots of mini eggs in the top, far more eggs than there would ever be in a bird's nest. And then there are some little yellow fluffy chicks that live in a jar in my kitchen drawer. And we put them on top. And this is what we do every year, and we eat it on Easter Sunday. Now that tiny little story makes a picture in your head, a probably very vivid picture, hopefully you like chocolate. It introduces you to some vocabulary you may not have heard before. So Easter you may not know, chick you may not know. You've probably heard of chocolate, I think that's the same in many languages. You may not have heard the word cake or the word bake. But if you were to repeat your listening to that little story lots of times, it would anchor those words in your head. You'd be very conscious of the nouns because they create pictures in your head, but actually the verbs that I'm using in that short piece would also begin to be part of what's unconsciously being learned. Now in my longer courses, I do a lot of pieces like that. So stories, pieces of information, interesting articles if you like. And I introduce particular words and phrases in them so that you learn them automatically. But also I'll do, for each one, I do a vocabulary piece, which is a somewhat longer recording of me just chit-chatting, just talking through the piece I recorded and explaining the vocabulary. Now, I never ever translate into another language. Everything is in English. Nothing but English, remember. So I'm just giving you an explanation of any difficult words in English. I'll find several different ways of saying the same thing so that you understand it and you learn to think in English. Now, things in context also get anchored. So Where there's context, it means there's a story, there's a picture around it. You know who's there, why they were there, when they were there, what it looks like, what it sounds like. I'll give you another example. If you were wanting to remember the word checkout, I could tell you a story about a woman, let's call her Sarah. She goes into the supermarket and she picks up her basket and she picks up some apples and some bread and some milk and maybe she gets some biscuits as well. And then she thinks, I want to go and pay. So she's there with her purse in her hand. Where does she walk up to? She walks up to the supermarket checkout. She puts her goods down on the belt and the checkout assistant says, oh, hello, would you like a bag? Are you having a nice day? Chit, chit, chat. And Sarah pays at the checkout for her goods and they get packed into her bag and out she goes to her car. Now, if you were to listen to this story several times, the word checkout is mentioned and it's mentioned in context. It's mentioned in the middle of a story. So your brain, she's really hardwired to do this, makes a picture, makes it useful, makes it anchored, so that you are going to remember the word checkout much more easily. But also what you're doing there is listening to a lot of verbs. So the usage for a verb gets into your unconscious bit and it will sound wrong if you do it, say it incorrectly. Now, I think apart from anchoring things in context, me giving you an explanation in English so that if there are any phrases or words you don't understand in the short pieces, I'm giving you a longer explanation. It means that you start to think in English and it takes you away from this necessity of translating into your own language. That's really important and it's a very, very powerful learning tool. Okay, that's probably enough on that one for today. And I look forward to seeing you tomorrow for Rule 6. Have a lovely day.